Urchinomics is about turning an environmental challenge into an economic, ecologic, and social opportunity. My name is Brian Tsuyoshi Takeda, and I'm the CEO and founder of Urchinomics. Sea urchins are quite amazing seafood products because they're essentially a flavor bomb. Sea urchins, they nibble and gnaw on kelp, which packs so many umami-rich amino acids. So when the urchins are eating the kelp, they're just piling up all of that flavor into the roe, which is what we eat. Today we face a very serious ecological challenge that most people don't know about because it happens to take place under the surface of the water. Due to an unfortunate combination of overfishing of predatory species, climate change, and pollution, we humans have created the perfect conditions for sea urchins to multiply and reproduce unhindered and overgraze and completely destroy entire kelp ecosystems. Now the problem with this is that kelp is essentially the nursery for our marine ecosystem. So that means that without kelp, you don't have fish. Without kelp, you don't have crustaceans or invertebrates. You essentially lose your entire marine resource. The problem with urchins that have occupied entire kelp forests and grazed it down to nothing is that they starve and they become empty. So there's nothing inside them. Fishers that are catching urchins have no interest in catching them because they have no economic value. And it seems to be that predators like crabs and fish, they seem to know that sea urchins are empty and they don't eat them. So suddenly, an urchin baron can persist for decades or even centuries, preventing any type of primary production from ever happening. What we do is we take the empty sea urchins that are occupying the ocean floor and we rehome them into our land-based ranching systems. We then feed them between 5 to 10 weeks, and we turn these empty, destructive sea urchins into commercially valuable seafood. By creating an economic incentive for the fishers, we can get these urchins out of the water and allow the oceans to heal itself. The kelp spores that are floating in the water column will settle quickly onto the ground and will turn back into a kelp forest within as quickly as 3 months. Now that becomes a three-dimensional habitat for fish, crustaceans, invertebrates, you name it, and it brings the ocean back to life again. So, restoring the kelp ecosystem not only contributes to our own ability to feed our people and our planet, but it also sequesters carbon. It also dampens the effects of wave-related erosion. It also seems to reduce the effects of ocean acidification in coastal communities. So by converting urchin barrens back into kelp forests, we can bring the greatest amount of good and generate profits and create jobs and sequester carbon and do all of that in one effort. For me, Urchinomics is an opportunity to prove that business can be a positive driver of change.